Okay. Now let's fix those parties. mine? Mine. I just love the visual of the two of them hanging off of him. He's the biggest lech in the world, so him getting exactly what he wanted is kind of funny. Yes, killing that one geezer would probably level him, so we're just gonna skip right over that then. Yes. Yep, we are getting on the train to Delling. Another train scene. You caught on! This train bound for Delling City will be departing shortly. As in right now. This is the only train bound for Delling City anyway. Okay. Perhaps it's fate. So what do we do about him? I don't want that Irvine guy using the guest room. Don't open it for him. Shouldn't you go check on Selfie? Yeah, we should probably rescue her. Selfie, we're destined to be together. Yeah, right. A sigh of love? No. Pardon me. Weirdo. My heart's pounding. What is this I'm feeling? It's an important mission. Get used to handling pressure while you still can. And that's not why her heart was pounding. Squall doesn't do feelings well, unless they're his own. Now he's gonna harass the next beautiful woman. Irvine, you're playing a major role in this mission. Now behave yourself. No one understands me. He's gonna go emo in a corner. Sharpshooters are loners by nature. We hone our instincts, pour our whole being into a single bullet. The pressure of the moment, an instant of tension. That's what I have to face alone. Just go it's not easy. Just shut up now. Just do me a favor and let me be. I will happily. There was no damage to the train from that minor vibration. Alright, now we're on our way to Delling. The train bound for the desert will be going from platform 1. Can I go to a different place? Oh, okay. Back here. Okay. Let's just go down the escalator. Or up the escalator. Caraway's mansion, right? Just take bus 08. We're going there already? You don't want to check out the city? That might be good. Maybe Laguna's back from his duties. But what do we do if I see him? We should go see General Caraway first. So this is where Laguna's from. So Renoa's obviously been here before. General Caraway's mansion's right through this gate, but I can't just let you walk in. I believe he's been informed of our arrival. Yes, indeed, but I was ordered not to let you through until your skills have been tested. He's still so skeptical of people. Test our skills? What does he want us to do? The Tomb of the Unknown King is at the northeast. All you have to do is go there. It's real simple, but you have to bring back proof that you were there, a code number. A code number? All the way out here for a test of courage? There are many students like yourself who wish to call on General Caraway. There was a student from Galbadia Garden yesterday who has yet to return from the test at the Tomb of the Unknown King. The Tomb of the Unknown King is located northeast of the city. Your objective is to go to the Tomb of the Unknown King, look for traces of this lost student, and return with his ID number. You should be able to find what you're looking for shortly after you go in. The ID number should be written on it. I don't recommend going any further than you have to. You may never make it back alive. Anyway, there's a map for you. Press the M key while inside the Tomb of the Unknown King to bring it up. Ta-da! Press the right arrow again while the map is displayed to escape from the dungeon. But just remember, your seed rank will go down. Alright, I'll accompany you. It's quite convenient if you rent a car while you travel outside. I don't think so. There we go. So, the next thing that we have to do is go way the crap up here. Let's save. This little hovel thing is the Tomb of the Unknown King. This is a Thrust Avis. It's kind of annoying. Oh yes, and I also got her mug, which is nice. Okay, now we're here to the Tomb of the Unknown King. So they just came running out of there saying something about float. Oh nice, apparently she doesn't have any protects. Okay. There we go. So we're going to do a little more than just get the missing student's ID number. We'll actually get to see that in a second. 189. Just going to quickly scribble that down. I think it's different every time you play the game, so you'll have to come here no matter what. We're gonna actually explore this place, and the way that I like to do it is I just keep going right every opportunity that I get. I find that's the easiest way because it's very easy to lose your sense of direction. Every time you change screens... Ooh. Oh. Okay. We woke up a thing, it looks very mean. Does this matter? His name is Sacred. He's got stuff. What's this? Oh, he's got life. Let's take everything. Okay, now we're gonna fight him. I don't know why I summoned Siren, but it's happening. I've actually summoned Diablos a lot for some of the lower health and the helps when I was running around earlier grinding, because my character, like those little geezers, they only have 85 hit points about. My characters do an average vote of about 60 to 70. Before upgrading his weapon, just as strong as a member of the party. Almost every respect, which is pretty humorous. But, yeah. So I was summoning him instead of attacking because it was much safer when you get your hit points down and make them easier to card, because if I crit them, then they would die. And that would make Squalking experience, and we don't want that. Anyway, here's Siren. She does a minimal amount of damage as well, but she also silences enemies. I'm not sure that this guy's Sacred can be silenced, but I thought it was worth a shot. Nope, okay. And you can't summon anything. Let's do the hurdy ones. And the reason why you need float for these guys is because they actually regain hit points the longer their feet are on the ground. Holding down M is high for the party. No, don't you dare. They're pretty strong. Yeah, we are. Bastards, it ain't over. And he's gonna run away. That thing lifts and we get to save our game. Yay!